Listen to this. Did you know that children miss an average of 22 million days of school due to illness? Well, now is a great time to talk about keeping germs away this school year as it gets underway for most area students right after Labor Day. Well, we welcome business owner and germ expert Chris Sweeney to Virginia this morning. Chris, it's a wonderful to see you, my man.
Thank you very much for having me.
Chris, tell us how prevalent germs are. I know we've seen it and heard about it for so many years. You can't see them. They're there. How prevalent are they, even on this set, just in an everyday office building?
I think if you saw it visibly, it would scare all of us. It's everywhere. I mean, there are germs and bacteria, there are viruses, there's fungus. It's producing constantly and reproducing constantly.
It's reproducing constantly.
Absolutely.
So how do we maintain? How do we control? How do we get ahead of it?
Well, personally, obviously using hand sanitizers as much as possible for kids, washing their hands on a regular basis, that's good prevention. Cross-contamination is probably the biggest proponent in schools that is a major factor. And so being able to educate students, teachers, parents, and owners of either child development centers to be more aware of what's going on and how they can prevent it are really key factors in trying to minimize it.
Chris, are we seeing more germs in places like child development centers, daycares, and schools?
I'm not sure if there's more germs. I think we've just become a lot more aware of them. I think the technology is out there right now, and the awareness and the measurement tools to really find how much bacteria and fungus are in these facilities has just made us all a lot more conscientious about it.
And we heard that kids miss, on average, 22 million days of school a year. That's not a good number.
Not a good number.
What are some of the things that we can do to really get a hold on this, get a stranglehold on these germs?
Well, if I'm a parent walking into a child development center or a school, I'm going to look at four different areas when I walk into a facility. The first thing I like to check out is the vents, because there's a lot of dust and mold that can be reproduced and circulated throughout a facility.
Interesting.
In any kind of school or a child development center.
So look up, not just down.
That's correct. Second is look down, though. I'm always going to check out the floors to make sure, are they being properly maintained? Are there cracked tiles? I'm always paranoid about the carpets, because the carpets can hold a lot of bacteria. And how often is a facility shampooing their carpets, particularly during flu season?
Tell us about some of the disinfectants we have here that we can
use. Well, bleach is old school, and so if I'm walking in the facility and I smell bleach, that's a nightmare for me, because there's so much great technology out there now that can, all these are neutralizers and disinfectants that are spray and wipe appropriate. We use a lot of color-coded cloths that are microfiber, so we're actually absorbing rather than pushing things side to side. And each of these would be designated for specific areas in the facility so that you're not cross-contaminating. You're not using the same cloth on a bathroom sink that you might use wiping somebody's desk.
So bleach might be a little bit of a problem. Red flag, it's old school, but might not be good for your school.
It's the product is fantastic. It's just the side effects and all of it. So as a professional cleaning company, we also do not use any over-the-counter products in any of our facilities. Everything we do is commercial grade, green, clean, eco-friendly for everybody.
Does it start at the very young? Get them in a good habit of cleaning?
Absolutely. I think with parents, getting kids used to washing their hands on a regular basis is paramount to really preventing cross-contamination. And particularly, parents need to realize, too, that as fast as we're running in the morning trying to get everybody ready to go to school, if your child is sick, you need to keep them home, because the reason those days are so high on missed schools is because of cross-contamination.
Mm-hmm. And speaking of cross-contamination, we have a lot of these products. You said look up at the vents, look down at the carpet and floor. But also, kids are going to be handling a lot of these books, a lot of the markers and pens and notebooks. How do you stay safe?
Well, I think one of the things for parents is that if your kids are bringing books and things to school, that make sure you can wipe them down with damp cloths that have bacterial disinfectants in them. And for schools and child development centers, I'm always looking to see, are there stations throughout the facility where you're using sanitizing wipes? Some of the commercial sanitizing wipes, like I brought with me today, have over almost three times the effect of a Clorox wipe. Excuse me, three times the effect of a Lysol wipe, and 2.5 times more bacteria kills than a Clorox wipe. So the commercial grade wipes are much better at eliminating cross-contamination potential.
And are these available to the public, or do we have to contact a professional? Because those wipes at least a good start for us?
They are a good start, but these are commercial grade, so typically they're not available through the stores yet. And a lot of these products are truly made for commercial grade application.
And not paper towels, you have something like this. Is this a...
microfiber cloths. We use microfiber everything. The old days of the stick and broom of just pushing dirt side to side are gone. And so all the microfiber products actually absorb the dirt and take it out of the facility. So we're actually cleaning the facility and moving dirt out of it.
How often should you clean?
Every day.
Every day?
In a facility, every day needs to be cleaned, absolutely. That's something I check also when I'm checking out schools is how often are they cleaning? Is it a professional service coming in to do it? Mm-hmm. And the key for us is making sure that the staff is working throughout the day while we're doing our job at night to make sure the facility is getting the clean that it really deserves.
Keeping the schools and child development centers clean. We've got quite an education right here. Chris, it's a pleasure, my man.
Thanks for the time.
Wonderful. You got it. All right. Thanks for...